fun. I think they're wonderful gift ideas for the holidays or really any time of the year. Okay, first of all, what you need is a material called Silky Solids. And I've already cut all this, but I wanted to show you how to fold it because it's really super easy. You're going to take a half a yard of Silky Solids material and you're going to fold it once from the salvage edge and then fold it back again. So you're going to actually have six layers of material. This is doubled, so we've doubled it three times, that's six. I know my math. Okay, next what you're going to do is for each flower pin, what you need is two large circles, and we're going to use the circle die for that, and you need one set of the small circles. So what I'm going to do here with my material to make it super duper easy, there's no cutting involved, is, whoops, I'm just going to fold it over and double it up. You're going to place it on your die, just like this. Oh, I've got things falling. Put your plate on the top, plate on the bottom, and you're going to run it through your machine just like this. All this extra material, it'll just stay right there. You just run it right through. Okay, then you're going to take those circles out, and you're going to bring in your smaller circle die, and you're going to put that leftover piece down here on that, and just stuff your material in here, put both your plates on the top and the bottom, and you're going to run that through your machine. I wish I could show you that, but my first video did not work and I cut up all my materials. Sorry. Okay, once you have all your circles, again, you're going to need two large circles for each clip and four circles from the smaller circle die and also a felt backing. And when I did the felt backing, what I did with that is I took my felt, I'm just going to fold it in half here because it's easy, and I cut a strip and then I folded it up into fours. Whoops, let's just fold it in half here and then fold it again, and you can place that right on your die on that second to the smallest circle and run that through your machine. It'll cut it all at once. I love my Big Shot. Have you seen the quilt projects? People are quilting with these machines. They're fabulous. Fabulous time saving for cutting out material. Okay, here's four felt backings for our pins cut all at once. Just going to set that aside. Okay, now we're done with our Big Shot for the moment. Next, what you're going to do is you're going to take your circles and you're going to apply some heat to them. Here's my candle. You can apply a little bit of heat just to curl the edges up. Okay, do you see what that's doing? And that's going to make you a nice flat pin. Or you can apply a lot of heat and actually get a little coloring on your edges, which I think is really cool because it makes your clip look a little more vintage. So you have to do two big circles and one of each of the other size circles. So here's our first one. Notice it's a little brown around the edges. I like that. And the second piece is a little different. You're going to curl your edges just like the first piece. Maybe curl them even a little bit more, but because both of these circles are the same size, we need one of them to layer in on top a little bit smaller. Don't start anything on fire. I'm not responsible for any fires. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring this in on top of the heat and watch it shrink. See it shrinking up? That's going to make this circle a little smaller. Be careful. You might burn some holes in there. Don't panic. They all get covered up when you start layering your flowers. So all the holes get covered up. Don't worry about it. Okay, so I've already done these three pieces. I've already got those done. Here's the smaller one. And then I wanted to show you the smaller pieces. Use a little tweezers to hold them so you don't burn yourself, because these are really little. This is a really fast and easy project. Okay, there's all four of our pieces, little circles. Now what you're going to do is you're going to come in with a glue gun and you're going to glue your flower layers together. apply some glue to the middle. Put your flower layer right in there. Oops. Be careful with your hot glue. Somebody was doing this yesterday at my house and they really burned themselves. I felt bad. Some more glue. Your next largest petal layer. And some more glue. Here comes your next petal. And your next one. How pretty is this? Make sure those are all sticking down in there. Next one. You can pull off all these little strings from your glue after it dries good. And then what I did is I took one of our antique brads and I used my craft and paper or craft and rubber scissors to cut the prongs off the back. That's going to be my centerpiece. You could use anything here. You could use a rhinestone brad. You could use a button, whatever tickles your fancy. Okay. So how cool is that? And notice that this flower is a lot more antique looking because I actually put it in the flame. Okay, last but not least, if you would like to put a hair clip on this, you're going to attach your clip like this. You're going to spread glue all over this side and glue it to the back. What I'm going to do is put a pin back on it. So I'm going to put glue all over, put that right in the middle of my flower, and then run a strip of glue for my pin back. Set that right down in there. And let that dry, and voila, you have a wonderful gift. Now I wanted to show you something that I made. I took the Fancy Favor box, and this is the Fancy Favor box, and I modified it to make it look smaller. So now I have this wonderful box, and it will fit my flower pin right in there, and what a great gift packaging idea. I will be doing a video on these in the next few days. I will put that on my blog, so make sure you watch for that. And here are some other flowers that I just wanted to share. This pink one, you'll notice, is much smaller. All I did with this is I did not put those last two big circles on here. I just used two of the larger circles and then went down from there with the rest of the circles. Put a rhinestone brad in the middle, little barrette on the back. Wonderful gift idea. Thank you for crafting with me today. And as always, you cannot craft or stamp without chocolate. Every day is so wonderful.